Well, hello.
Welcome to KJ Vlog.
I'm going to be continuing with the story tonight of Life is Strange Before the Storm. This, by the way, Drew, is not the same thing as Life is Strange 2 that I was talking about buying. Life is Strange 2 is about two boys. Okay, we're going to continue on. If you remember, in the last episode we ended, Chloe was going to school, riding to school in her car, and saw her dad driving in some kind of flash, and there's this big wreck. By the way, I'm still going to continue to play other games. I need to get PlayStation Plus back. I'll probably do that in a couple of days, and I'll keep going with Batman. I guess I'll keep putting Red Dead stuff on here, because I'm assuming you probably want to watch it. I just hate to spoil the game for you, some of the missions, but I'll put them on here, give you something to watch. And then I still got those other games I want to buy,
too. Out of the car, Chloe. You're going to be late.
Okay, so she's arrived at school now after the crash.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Recognize the school from the first Life is Strange?
Hello, Black Hal.
Remember when they went to art class and the teacher there was the killer? Looks exactly the same. It's pretty cool. And here we are. This is like, I guess, years before that. Because this is before Max comes back. Right now Max is in Seattle.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night.
I didn't do a very good job of making her a black eye on here.
People are talking about it.
It just looks like makeup.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
I'll say maybe.
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. Elliot, who was Elliot?
Cam.
Yeah.
Was he in the other game? What was the name of Elliot? Was he the who was the kid that was selling
Chloe
the drugs?
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Remember the bad guy whose father basically owns the school? What was his name? Was that Elliot? I don't think so.
Well, at least not for now.
Text. Steph, I'm at the picnic tables with Mikey. Oh, okay, that's right, because she has her DVD. Okay. Let's go explore over here. I guess they're putting on a play. Do not walk on a stage.
Huh. Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage.
a crate. There's a crate up there. What's in it? How do I get up here? I'm walking on it. What's in this? Oh, something to sit on? Okay. Looks like you're sitting on the toilet.
I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care. Did last night really happen? The internet says it did, but I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber. Uh-oh, it's the principal. I remember him.
Principal Wells. Hey. Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana-flavored bag of expulsion in your pocket.
Chloe Price. Is that a black eye?
Yep.
I still don't see the black eye.
That Blackwell provides confidential counseling services for all our students. We are a safe space for any issue.
I'm good. It's the other guy who needed a safe space. From me.
You never fail to conform to your reputation, do you? Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
Blah, blah, blah. I didn't do it, I swear.
I swear to you, I did not walk on that stage. It was more of a saunter.
Do I look amused to you?
I don't know. I've only seen you with one expression. That's the one.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero tolerance policy. And yet, if my olfactory sense does not fail me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price?
No.
That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
Let's try to talk him out of it.
Wells really has it out for me. I have to convince him it's in his best interest to back off. Actually, sir, I'm gonna go with no.
Ah, so you're going to mouth off to me now, yes?
Man, all I gotta do
and
is
here
lose.
I thought your well of witticisms had finally run dry.
All I gotta do is lose once.
Oh, I get it. Because your name is Wells, right? You go around all day just hoping for an opportunity to make well references? This must be a big moment for you.
Jokes? In my experience, that's how the guilty cover up their infractions.
How did you become principal without learning the Constitution? The Fourth Amendment, illegal search and seizure?
We are a private institution. And policy allows me to search all students on the premises.
Hey, honesty is the best policy, right? So I guess I should tell the truth about all the drug use going on at the school. To you, to the Beacon, to anyone who asks.
I'm sure we, do not need to make so public an issue of your behavior today. But make no mistake, Miss Price, this is not over.
Ooh, goody. I love cliffhangers. Funny, just a couple years ago, something like that would have scared the crap out of me. These days, I'm at, like, the collegiate level of not giving any fucks.
So I just talked my way out of going to the principal's office. What else can we look at?
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Yeah, let's go over here. I remember this part of the game. This is really fun. We play a game of Dungeons and Dragons. It's really cool. It's actually probably my favorite part of this game. Ha ha! 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 I wonder if I could talk to these people. see who this is. Samantha.
Samantha Myers, school wallflower. She could give you...
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
It's sad.
The story is about how relationships only work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe.
What?
No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
All right. She's a weirdo. See what she says if I talk to her again.
I really didn't mean anything.
All right. Oh, it's Victoria. Remember the girl in the first one? We spilled the paint on her off the building, and, you know, the stuck-up girl, sorority girl, chick.
Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
Ah, oh, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. Carrie. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex
Club, it's
hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
We murdered a man.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know? I mean, look at your face.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're... being you. Oh! Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
I should have sabotaged her homework. I think that stuff over there. Let's see who this is. Remember the dorms were back that way?
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's Evan. Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What soapbox is he on today?
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
Should we sign Chloe Price, Ivanis Ann Ass Clown, or Smokeweed D. Bear? I'll say that one.
Happy to support such an important cause.
Smokeweed D. Bear.
Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Thanks so much for signing my petition.
I should look to see what the other names were.
Smokeweed D. Bear?
Only you can prevent ganja fires.
All right, let's go get our DVD.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet.
$5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey. Do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber?
Rachel.
You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
Why do you want to know?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join her game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Sure.
What the hell. Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Are you insulting me in some obscure nerd way?
Think about it. An elf? Like, skinny and kind of weird, but also a barbarian, so, like, really angry.
In other words, Chloe Price.
Wow, you two are a riot.
All right, let's get started. You were both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you and greet you. I am Elamah, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
It says right here that I taught your precious King Tiberius everything he knows about fighting. So, Elamon, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
You gave her that, elf barbarian.
I did.
Elamon bows deeply. I've heard of you in the castle. King Tiberius owes you his life. It's an honor to fight alongside you.
Damn straight.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the Raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The Raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Go to the Warlord's tent.
It's tent time.
Are you sure you want to skip the training ground and the prison camp?
Okay, let me pick again.
Where do you wish to go?
Training ground.
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Oh,
holy shit!
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Do a pummel strike.
I do a pummel strike. I strike his pommel hard. What did I say?
A pommel is the end of a sword handle. Pommel strike is where you hit the guy with it.
Oh, damn it. Okay, I do that.
Except you're not wielding a sword, you're wielding an axe.
This sucks.
It's all right. Try using your...
You've delayed too long. The orc swings his warhammer at your head, barely missing. Your move.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! Yummy. I'm awesome at this game!
An orc hot dog.
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
My character raises her axe. You'll pay for ruining all that loot, Elamon.
By my honor, I apologize. Here, take this potion as a gift.
Thanks, dude.
What's next?
What was that, a piece of candy? Prison
camp. Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages. Each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Tempt with bread?
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Ugh. Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
I wiggle my hand. Hey, Dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass, into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The Dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you ki. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
You're short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
The Dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
That's a good Dungeons and Dragons game.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly Dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Did some damage.
I want to punch that stupid man-cow in the dick.
Like, okay. Right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
You miss. Durgaron bursts out laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
1?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elamon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do? I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I'll swing for his arm.
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon!
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Maggie's got serious drawing skills.
I guess that's supposed to be Calamastia. And what's his name?
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
I wish there was a video game where you just played those all the time. That was kind of fun.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
All right. I feel like we didn't even hardly do anything in this game other than play Dungeons and Dragons, but I mean, this video is already like, I think it's like a half hour long or more, so I'll continue in the next video. I'll see you later.